So now that I've had a chance to wear the Nike Air Max 270 a little bit more, I want to give you guys a detailed review and my final thoughts on the Air Max 270. This is the very first Nike model that features the lifestyle of Air. That's right, you did hear that correctly. This is actually the very first Air ever that is created to have a more lifestyle. So that is kind of a big step forward. Some of the inspiration from the Air Max 93. You can see the collar looks fairly similar from the 93 as it's all one piece and a connected tongue. Also from the size of the shoe, you could see that this panel right here is very similar. Some may argue that the toe piece actually came from the 93, not from the 180. You can see they obviously minimize the swoosh. And here's a side-by-side look at the soles. So honestly, they say that this took inspiration from both of those models. I don't really see a lot of heavy inspiration, which is kind of nice because it gives you an opportunity to get a different shoe. And if you don't like the other two models, there's still a chance that you can actually like this one. So as I mentioned, it's 32 millimeters tall, which is bigger than the VaporMax. For those wondering and wanting to see a side-by-side, it's a bigger air unit in the back than the VaporMax. I think this is pretty noteworthy because this is such a huge air bubble on the back. It really is significant amounts of air. So a quick overview on the shoe. You can see it is a mesh upper, and I believe they do have a Flyknit version of this shoe coming out. So if you don't like the mesh upper, maybe the Flyknit one will be better. Personally, I am excited to see what those ones look like in hand and on feet. The air unit is just massive, as you can see again, 270 degrees around the shoe. And you have that Hyperfuse materials on the sides of the shoe for a little bit of extra reinforcement. And then you have a little bit of a kind of a nylon heel cage. And then it has a Nike Air logo on the back. You do have an Air 270 pull tab on the shoe, as well as a little bit of a different Air Max branding on the insole. You have the Air 270 logo on the tongue. If you didn't look at this properly, it could look like it says Air 70. You also have another 270 on the side and a 270 on the inside of the shoe as well. So a lot of people are probably wondering what this foam is in the front of the shoe. Honestly, I feel like this is a missed opportunity by Nike. They could have done React in the front and then the air unit, the 270 air unit in the back. Unfortunately, this is just a dual density foam. And it's nice, but it's just regular foam. It's nothing fancy, nothing special. I do like the bottom of the shoe, however, and all of the different textures to the soles. It's not just one singular piece of rubber. There's obviously the huge air unit here. You have some softer foam on the inside of the shoe, and then in the middle, you could see that this is actually a little bit of a harder rubber. So without wasting too much more of your time, I wanted to get into some of the things that I really like about this shoe. So the first thing I really like about this Air Max 270 is it took something that is basically potentially a gimmick from this model right here, the Nike Air Max 1, in its original inception, and the idea that you can be walking on air, and kind of it was mocked back in the day, and then all of a sudden, like 32 years later, is it? 31 years later, you have a pair of sneakers that is completely revamped, but still using the same fundamental technology of air in the midsole. I like that Nike has taken something, and they keep evolving it year after year, and we see something even cooler this year than we've seen in the previous. I love the fact that they're taking an old technology and new technologies and delivering a redesigned, reimagined product that consumers old and new can enjoy. The other thing that I really like and appreciate about this model is that it is made for lifestyle. It's definitely a comfortable sneaker and something that's fun to be able to put on your feet, and it definitely draws a lot of attention with that huge, colorful air bubble. As I mentioned, this air bubble is bigger than the VaporMax, so you definitely can feel it when you do some heel transition, and you can feel and you can visibly see the air bubble compressing and then decompressing with every single step. And something that I like about this model more so than even the VaporMax is I mentioned this in my review of the VaporMax. It definitely has an interesting air feeling and one you have to get used to, but that heel-toe transition is so bizarre because you can actually feel all the segments as you're transitioning from heel to toe, and it feels a little bit wonky as you're transitioning. But in this shoe, you just have the huge air bubble in the back, And as you transition forward, you don't feel that clunkiness from the heel to toe. So you might actually like this one better than the VaporMax if you don't like that transition. So the big question a lot of people are asking, is this shoe comfortable and is it better than React? I really think it's hard to compare technologies, to be quite frank. They're not the same. I mean, and everybody has different feet and everybody's preferences are going to be different. If you're a huge fan of Nike Air historically, this is going to be a fun shoe for you to try out because there's no pair of sneakers on the market that I know of that you can feel the air more in the heel than you can in this shoe right here. So if you like that feeling of air in the shoe, and if you're not using it for performance, this shoe is awesome and it's super fun to try on because it offers such a huge air bubble on the back. Is it groundbreaking technology? Probably not. I mean, it sinks down quite a bit and there's not too much crazy cushioning in the front of the shoe. You're not getting React, you're not getting Lunarlon, but it's still a comfortable shoe. I mean, on a scale of like 1 to 5, it's just a 3. Like, it's not anything crazy good, but it's definitely not something bad. And I say, yes, it's a comfortable shoe, but no, it's not like Nike React, and no, it's not like Boost or anything like that. For me, there's more of a nostalgic point to this shoe, the fact that it's flexing Nike's air in the best way possible in 2018. But the reality is this isn't the most comfortable pair of sneakers that you can throw on, and it's definitely a unique feel to your feet, but it's nothing that's earth-shattering or groundbreaking in my opinion. The only thing that I really don't love about this shoe is the fact that it's a little bit snug in this section right here. And once again, that's just my personal preference. I don't love when the tongues are super connected like this, but maybe the Flyknit version of this will offer some more stretch in the tongue area and a little bit more relaxed feel. Some people have complained that the shoe runs a little bit narrow also. I have pretty wide feet, but I didn't have any problems with the narrowness of the shoe. So my final thoughts on the Air Max 270, is it worth buying? Yes, if you're a Nike head and you love Nike Air, for sure it's a great addition to your Nike Air collection. If you're only able to buy one brand new pair of shoes a year and you're looking for something with a maximum amount of comfort for the price point, my personal preference is the Nike Epic React for cushioning. But this shoe on feet is really good. It's just average though, I would say. It's pretty much average across the board. Stability, cushioning, responsiveness, weight, durability, traction, everything across the board is a 3 on this shoe. It's just average. But again, if you really like that Nike Air on the back of the shoe, then this is definitely a must try for you airheads. I said airheads. I do love that this is a celebration of that air and it has a nod to some of the classic models out there without overtaking the entire shape of the shoe and make you think that you're getting a newer version of an old shoe. But what do you guys think about the Air Max 270? Is it a shoe that you have given a try or not? Is it something that you guys are not interested at all? Leave a comment in the comment section. Curious to see what you guys have to say about trying the shoe or not wanting to try this model. Thank you guys for watching this video. And if you guys want to see a review of the Nike Force 270, stay tuned and I will have a review on this shoe. This shoe is dope, by the way. I love the fact that this pull tab comes across like this in a magnetic form. This might just be my new favorite model this year so far, just because of the aesthetics of the shoe. I think it looks so, so clean. So stay tuned for a review of these. So if you guys are looking to buy the Air Max 270, just go ahead and check the link in the description and I will take you to a couple of places to be able to cop. Also, if you guys like this video, if you don't mind dropping a thumbs up on the video, it goes a long way and it is much appreciated. But thank you guys for stopping by and watching the video. If you guys want to see some other videos on my channel, go ahead and click the screen at this time. And have a good rest of the day. Thanks, guys.